So here I am. I want to. Hari said it's an endowment lecture. I want to correct that impression. This is not a lecture. This is sharing some of the experiences of building Dr. Reddy's along with my colleagues, along with Dr. Reddy, and working closely with Satish. We built this institution, and this is the story of Dr. Reddy's, not really about Dr. Reddy. But before I get there, I just want to, you know, say a few words about our, you know, chairman who just passed away last year. He founded this company in 1985 with a great deal of passion. And he, you know, being a scientist, was very, very driven by innovation, by a pioneering spirit of doing something for the first time in this country. These are things which drove him. And he also had a great spirit of generosity and also of encouraging positive work by anybody who was around him. So in a way, you know, I and my brother-in-law Satish, who built Dr. Reddy since the early 90s, had a great ride. We had enormous freedom. We made a lot of mistakes. We learned from mistakes. And he, you know, always saw the positive things in what we did and gave us limitless freedom and limitless encouragement. And today, this institution is largely because of that spirit of entrepreneurship, encouragement, and generosity in spirit that he had. So I just wanted to pay homage to him as we talk a little bit about how we built Dr. Reddy's. With all that, I think, you know, when he started getting restless about something, he would delegate that off completely. And you know, the businesses, almost from mid-90s, he never got fully involved into the businesses. He moved away from the businesses, focused on research, focused on innovation, and just meeting, you know, important people around the world. And you know, in that process, he delegated to Satish and me a lot of the responsibilities, and we had a free hand in running the organization. So in the mid-90s, we started globalizing. We not only went abroad for marketing our products and selling things, but also went to acquire research presence, develop manufacturing internationally, and all of those. And some of these, you know, really helped us as we, you know, became bigger and more global. But they really, you know, I just want to talk a little bit about this purpose that he really focused us on. And there were two things to it, two aspects to it. The first one was about affordability. And this is a common thread in everything we do in all our businesses. Driving affordability, improving access to medicines, and accelerating, you know, the availability of these medicines to as many people in the world as possible. This was really the simple purpose that he drove in us. In the 90s, he started looking at drug discovery, unmet medical needs, and research. And that is the innovative part that you see in our purpose. So affordability and innovation were the you know, two pillars of our purpose. But we want to say that business can be a force for good. It can generate positivity. It can solve many of society's problems, create wealth for everybody, and generally be an engine for uplifting people's lives. So with that philosophy, we manage the company and the impact we have on society as well as on all our stakeholders. The second thing relates to really our people practices. And we're still evolving here, but there's a fundamental belief that every employee comes to work to do a great job. And hence, if you give him the right context, he will do the right thing. He doesn't need supervision, he doesn't need control. So there must be a sense of empowerment. One word is empowerment, other word is learning. So you have to invest in building the capability of your people. And many of my past colleagues tell me that the journey at Dr. Reddy's was greatest for me because I learned a lot here. And that learning has made me a better person and a more valuable professional in the industry. So learning and empowerment are the two things that we really offer to our people. And that's again helped us build the organization into a much more competitive and powerful organization.